Have you heard what Elon Musk said? You can have a Neuralink chip in your head as cheap as an Apple Watch, and in just 600 seconds, or 10 minutes. Yes, you heard me right. But is that even possible? And if yes, why so cheap and why so fast? Let's dive in and see what this really means. By the end, I want to know, would you go for it? All right, for those who might be new to Neuralink, let's catch up. Founded by Elon Musk, Neuralink is pioneering a brain-computer interface, or BCI, designed to bridge the gap between human brain and technology. Neuralink gained FDA approval in 2023 for human trials. And in January 2024, they made history by implanting the first chip into a human brain, Nolan Arba, also known as P1. Nolan, who's quadriplegic, was able to use the chip immediately, even spending his first night with it playing video games. Since then, Neuralink team has regularly tracked the Nolan progress, which hasn't been without challenges. Early on, many of the tiny threads implanted in his brain retracted due to an air pocket oversight in his surgery setup. The team learned quickly, refining the process, and by June 2024, Neuralink performed a second successful implant. Now they are planning for more trial in 2025 and aiming for widespread use by 2030. For better understanding, let's break down this procedure, the N1 implant, the R1 robot, and the surgical steps involved. Only then can we see if a 10-minute implant really makes sense. Now, let's look a bit closer at what involved in this groundbreaking procedure. First, the N1 implant. This compact, coin-sized device is designed to sit in the brain. It's equipped with ultra-thin flexible threads that are finer than human hair, each carrying electrodes to detect neural signals. These threads are designed to interface seamlessly with brain tissue, minimizing any damage and maximizing accuracy. The implant wirelessly transmits brain signal to external devices, allowing users to control computers or smartphones with their thoughts. Now, on to R1 robot, the surgical robot developed by Neuralink for placing the N1 implant. This robot uses advanced imaging and an ultra-thin needle to insert threads with high precision into targeted brain regions. The robot's precision reduces human error and lowers the risk of tissue damage. Together, N1 implant and R1 robot form the backbone of this entire process. Now, let's walk through the surgery itself, starting with preparation. The surgical procedure begins with pre-operative assessment, including imaging and neurological evaluation to find the best placement for the implant. When surgery day comes, the patient's skull needs to be partially open to allow the implant to be securely placed, a step often done through a small craniectomy. Once access is established, the R1 robot carefully inserts the N1 implant thread into a specific brain region associated with movement. The entire procedure is designed to be minimally invasive, and patients are typically discharged the following day. But that's not the end. Post-surgery, patients receive ongoing follow-up to monitor the implant and help them learn to use it effectively. The Neuralink team provides rehabilitation support, ensuring patients can fully integrate the technology into their daily lives. Here is where things get complicated. Even if Neuralink claims the implant itself can be done in just 10 minutes, consider everything involved. From locating the ideal brain area, ensuring the safe skull access, positioning the device, and inserting the delicate threads, each of these steps take precision and time. And let's not overlook post-operation care. Cutting down surgery time is appealing, but in reality, precision still takes priority over speed. So while the 10-minute implant might technically be possible for the placement of the device, the full experience of testing, surgery prep, and recovery is much larger time commitment. And for something critical as brain surgery, should the speed really be the top priority? Now, let's talk the dollars. Musk claimed that Neuralink implant could be as cheap as an Apple Watch. But what's behind that price? Consider the cost. A high-tech medical device, advanced imaging, the surgical robot, and the team of specialists. Not to mention the cost of ensuring data security, because this technology requires serious measures to keep your brain data safe. So why make the device cheaper than it really costs? Is it to increase the accessibility? Or could there be another motive? It's a bold move to make such a complex technology affordable, especially when there is still the cost of security and privacy. It leaves us wondering if this affordability might come at a different price. Here is where things get a bit concerning. I'm all for making technology accessible, but when something as complex and specialized as brain implant is made affordable and promised in just 10 minutes, it raises some big questions. Imagine this, a procedure that instead of taking hours is marketed to happen in just 600 seconds. By reducing the time, Neuralink aims to push more people through these surgeries, rapidly scale up the number of implants. But why the rush? Why the race to make it so cheap and fast that everyone can get one? Could it be more than accessibility? Think about it. A device that affordable, quick to implant, and eventually available to everyone could position Neuralink as a primary company with access to an unprecedented amount of real-time brain data. We are talking about neural activity, reactions, emotions, data that is immensely valuable and powerful. This isn't just about making life easier. It could mean creating the largest brain data repository ever, with Elon Musk and Neuralink at the helm. With real-time insight into how we think and feel, this data wouldn't just be valuable. It would give Neuralink a unique kind of influence. It's one thing to innovate, but another to have access to someone as personal as person's thoughts at such a scale. So here is the question. With everything we have discussed, would you be willing to get a Neuralink chip in your brain? Let me know your thought in the comments below. I'm really curious to hear where you all stand on this. Please subscribe, like, and share this video if you find it useful. Thank you.
So the device itself in volume should not be super expensive. I mean, hopefully it's like, $5,000 to $10,000. And very high volume, it should start to approximate the cost of an Apple Watch or a phone. So maybe it's $1,000 or $2,000, something like that. And then if it's implanted with a robot, then that surgical procedure should be fast. Like we do have a game plan for what I call the 600 second surgery. So 10 minutes, you sit in the chair, and 10 minutes later, you have an implant. And we're not violating physics. Just as with LASIK, it goes in a laser, does a whole bunch of things to your eyeball. Now you'd have to automate basically everything here, but if you break it down second by second, it is possible to have a 600 second or 10 minute surgery. So at that point, if it's being done by a robot and the whole thing takes 10 minutes, I think it probably, the whole thing, all inclusive, ends up being, on the order of $5,000 maybe, similar to LASIK. Mm-hmm.